Airmen from the 621st Contingency Response Wing host a capstone ceremony at Joint Base McGuire-Dix-Lakehurst, New Jersey, June 26, finalizing the recent reorganization of groups within the wing.
This ceremony culminates over 4 years of hard work, dedication, and perseverance on the part of airmen and leaders at all levels to achieve today's final event. Today is just the tip of the iceberg. Below the waterline has been that tremendous amount of hard work by you to get it right for the Air Force's only wing specifically designed to execute expeditionary mobility operations on a global basis.
The ceremony began with the inactivation of the 621st Contingency Operations Support Group, signifying the completion of the wing's restructuring plan to enhance the effectiveness and efficiency of its global air mobility operations. Major General Frederick Martin, U.S. Air Force Expeditionary Center Commander, states,
I don't know if there's been a more significant time in our nation's history where we've called upon the CRW, where we have asked so much of you in changing as well as executing the mission.
The Bicoastal Wing, with units stationed at Joint Base McGuire-Dix-Lakehurst, New Jersey, and at Travis Air Force Base, California, previously had 6 groups. The reorganization process called for the inactivation of 17 units and the formation of 12 newly activated units structured into 3 groups.
We streamlined the top levels of command in order to give each squadron commander the resources, personnel, training, and span of control they needed to execute each specialized mission.
The new unit realignment streamlined the unity of command to maximize efficiency of the units as the demand for its rapid mobility mission continues across the globe. But not everything is changing.
What hasn't changed is the mission, the teamwork, and most importantly, the airmen of the CRW.
Reporting from Joint Base McGuire-Dix-Lakehurst, New Jersey.
Never later!
I'm Air Force Staff Sergeant Destiny Berry.